Good day, I am Benito E. Flores Daport, and I will be presenting a case study of a 40-year-old Caucasian female with unilateral retinitis pigmentosa. Authors are Denise Goodwin, Amanda Olsen, and Carl Sete. So, retinitis pigmentosa is a group of rare genetic disorder that causes loss of night vision, loss of peripheral vision, difficulty with dark adaptation, while unilateral retinitis pigmentosa is an uncommon entity involving the RP-like changes in one eye with the fellow eye completely unaffected. So this is about a 40-year-old Caucasian female which complained of a loss of vision and a black floating oval in her left eye. Patient is a former cigarette smoker with no history of retinitis pigmentosa. Her medical history shows first is gallbladder surgery and polycystic ovarian syndrome. Upon diagnostic test using automated Humphrey visual field, a macular optical coherence tomography, electroretinography, fundus autofluorescence, we found out that characteristics of retinitis pigmentosa in her left eye, but on her right eye, it's normal. So there is no treatment for retinitis pigmentosa. Vitamin A, some take vitamin A, which only slows down the deteriorating effect of RP. Then some gene therapy, but gene therapy is under investigation and further test is needed for approval, but has promising effect. So the patient is undergoing low vision assessment for low vision rehabilitation. So for low vision therapy, let us know first its purpose. So the purpose of low vision assessment is to assess the residual or the partial remaining vision, which is also known as the present vision, and correlate it with the patient's social, educational, vocational, and other needs, and to identify ways to enhance the residual vision and to maximize the visual acuity. So we have to determine the objectives of rehabilitation. First is to maximize visual acuity. Second, reduce the effect of glare and photophobia. Third is the orientation and mobility management. And fourth is the use of magnification devices. And fifth, field enhancement techniques. And lastly, referrals for additional rehabilitation services. So, low vision services may be helpful for patients with retinitis pigmentosa. So for the management of dark adaptation difficulties, we can use a simple pen light. So for example, for searching in dark cabinets or finding objects at night, then illuminated magnifiers and closed circuit televisions are helpful for reading and writing, also known as the near visual aids. Then for tunnel vision, we can use a reverse telescope. For night blindness, we can use infrared night vision scopes. And for the prevention of glare, we can use amber or yellow or orange filters or tints attached to spectacles. As a conclusion, including my own personal insights, unilateral retinitis pigmentosa is a rare condition. Why rare? Because most commonly retinitis pigmentosa affects two eyes bilateral, and there is no treatment for retinitis pigmentosa. So for low vision therapy, it is very helpful for the alleviation of vision, especially the remaining vision. So I also remember reading literature about the connection of retinitis pigmentosa and smoking, which says that every increase of pack of cigarette per year also increases per year the rate of deterioration of retinitis pigmentosa and the decrease in the field of vision. So if you are a smoker, please stop smoking. So as a low vision optometrist, it is our job to help patients become independent and maximize their residual vision or their visual acuity. So how we can help them first is by prescribing low vision devices, whether optical or non-optical devices, by visual rehabilitation, and most especially educating the patient about their visual problem and counseling them so about their visual problem also, and help them accept their visual condition to avoid creating further problems like depression. Thank you for listening. Hope you understand some little things.